va les sons et tout? How's it going, Straight Arrows? This is our pre-departure update.
Yeah!
Dans moins de 24 heures, nous serons dans un avion en direction de Vancouver, BC. Et je peux te dire que j'ai hâte de crisser mon camp d'ici parce que on gèle en ce moment. It's 31 degrees in Vancouver right now, 31 Celsius, which is very hot, and there's a heat wave. I'm sorry for all the people who are inconvenienced, but I'm really glad that it's gonna be warm where I'm going because it's freezing cold here right now. Not comfortable.
Comment tu te sens, Benchwell, avec du départ? J'ai vraiment, vraiment hâte de partir.
So as you watch this update, we are in the plane flying to Vancouver. Our plane is leaving Montreal at 6 p.m. on Sunday, August 1st.
Alors, que ben là, Pancho, tiens-toi de bout.
Before leaving, I had to take care of a lot of stuff. I'm leaving until November 9th, so maybe when I come back, there might be snow on the ground. I had to take care of stuff in the yard, in the house. And also, I was working double what I usually work to make the money that I didn't have, and I did not succeed. Because in the last week, I still had videos to put out and I had zines to print, and I put the priority on that because I could not do it after I leave. Basically, I'm gonna be short $1,000 on my budget when I leave, and I'm gonna have to work in Vancouver for like the first 10 days or something. I'm gonna have to like make $100 a day, every day, or try to make that $1,000 as quick as I can. Get this done because I did not want to be working on my vacation, but I have to because I do need some money for September. I need $2,000. I only have one now, so yeah, but I have the food money.
As long as you got the food budget.
I mean, accommodation is also kind of important, not to be homeless.
Yeah.
I went to the dentist. I always go to the dentist before leaving on a trip because it's nice to have clean teeth. And I have gingivitis problems because I develop a lot of plaque. So it's good, got rid of that. And I got to see my friends. Well, I didn't get to see all my friends. We couldn't make it work, but I got to see three of my friends. I saw Dantel, Christopher, and Véronique. Yeah, on est déjà en direct. Ouh, c'est Dantel et ça fait un an qu'on s'est pas vu.
Ouais.
Je vais te montrer quoi avec ma caméra. On pourrait me filmer, je vais vous l'envoyer.
Je vous présente un peu pour
sur le vif. Regarde, j'ai ma boisson. C'est drôle qu'à Québec, on n'a pas de misère à trouver du matcha latte alors qu'à Montréal, j'ai même pas capable d'en avoir.
We'll find the life jacket.
Best. Et j'ai une petite question pour toi. Toi qui as étudié le japonais, tu parles très bien japonais. Moi, je ne parle qu'une base, très minime. Le restaurant ici, ça s'appelle Tori. Et il y a ce, ce design un peu partout, je me demandais si ça avait rapport. Et qu'est-ce que ça veut dire, Tori?
Tori, c'est porte.
Ah, je savais pas.
Le portail, la porte. Come through the door.
Saint-Roch by night. I also went to see Marcel before leaving. He still cannot leave his house because he hasn't got his second dose of vaccine yet and he's 84 years old. But Madame Simard said that maybe when I come back, I could take him to the coffee shop. He hasn't been to the coffee shop or anywhere outside his house since March 2020. It's gonna be a year and a half. And you know, Marcel is a very social person. He can't read, so he doesn't use the internet. He doesn't have a phone number for himself. So he's been seeing not a lot of people, but he's holding on. Also, I've been doing a couple things in preparation of Vancouver. For example, I bought a MacBook. All right, we're gonna do something really stressful. You know that I've appreciated that this MacBook that's 20 years old has been paid by some of you. Thank you very much. I've appreciated it, but honestly, I can't wait to get a new one because this machine has done the job, but barely. It's very slow. It's lagging. It's been a little difficult to work with. And now, what are we gonna do? I'm buying a MacBook Air, a new one, brand new from the Apple website. I'm not bringing a computer in my suitcase. This is way too heavy. This is way too big. I need a MacBook Air. Also, it's a 13-inch, same as this. My old one was an 11. I'm basically going to click a button and spend $2,000. As you've seen my statement, the total amount is $2,126 and I have $2,131 as available credit. Yes, I like to play it close to the vest. Don't worry because I have $750 coming into my credit card really soon, plus two other paychecks. So I'll be okay. I'll have the money for September. August is already paid for. October is already paid for. And I have all my food money in a separate fund. So we can get that. Woo! This is exciting. And it's pink. It's gold, but it's kind of rose gold. I mean, are you ready? Hit pay. Woo! Pay $2,000. Dang, it's gone like that. Woo, it's done. Oh my God, it's done. I just bought a MacBook Air. Look. And then what I like to do is I love to read. On my vacation, I read every day and I read a lot of books. There are these little free book shelves in the city where I like to go get books. But I have a long list of books that I want to read and I have a working Vancouver library card because yeah, I have a Vancouver address, so they actually think I live there, which I do. What I do is I go on the internet and I put a hold on books because sometimes it can take a long time if the book you want is very popular. For example, Sapiens, I'm number 116 in line. I don't know if I'm gonna have time to get it before I leave. If not, I'll read it later. Loaded my monthly pass for August on my Compass card. This is my Vancouver bus pass. It's fully loaded, ready to use. If you're wondering what happened with the copier machine, it's a total disaster. It could not be repaired. The repairman tried, he couldn't. And then he told me he would have to send it to Canon, blah, blah, blah. I don't understand. It was working perfectly fine, and then bang, he sells some. So he said, I have one here that I can sell to you, and it's very hard to get parts, and it's very hard to get copiers, apparently, because of COVID, I don't know. So he said, here, I have this one. I haven't bought a copier for like 15 years, so I wasn't really aware of what I needed as a machine, and I bought this really cheap $300 home copier, and I tried to make my zines on it, and it doesn't work. Every time you make a photocopy, there was three sheets of paper coming out instead of one. It would make the photocopy, and then there would be two blank sheets every single time you make a copy, and I had to make thousands. Can you imagine? You had to set the settings every single time you had to make a copy. I can't do that. I want to be like 100, go, do it, you know? It was very, very, very annoying. There was no way I could have worked with that. So I called the guy back and I said, can I bring it back to you and you give me part of the money because it's used, the box has been opened, but it's practically brand new, and send mine to Canon because that photocopy machine cost me $1,000. 15 years ago, so it's a really good one. To buy a comparable one today would probably cost me at least $800. Pretty sure that sending it to Canon and having it repaired if possible is not gonna cost me $800. And I'd rather have it because it was perfect. I knew how to operate it, it was good. The guy is on vacation right now, I left a message, we'll see what he says. Worst case scenario, I'll have to buy a better one when I come back. So I had to go to Staples to do the 60 issues that I needed to reprint, and it cost me $150. When I had the copy machine, a stock of toner, and 5,000 sheets of paper at home. To say that I'm pissed is an understatement. But I did it, my zines are out. So if you wanna get the latest copy of my zine, Electron Libre number 2, which is subtitled COVID-19 and Border Wedding Edition. It was the worst of times, it was the best of times. For $5 postpaid, go on my Etsy, you can order it now. Yes, I'll have copies with me in Vancouver so I can mail them now and not in 3 months. Other than that, remember the little free store that we went to that I found the jacket, which I wish I had right now because I'm freezing. I went and I left some items that I wanted to donate as well. Il fait extrêmement chaud. Vous vous souvenez du magasin gratuit? Où est-ce que j'avais trouvé mon super complet? Et ensuite, je suis revenue chercher ma petite étagère que j'ai mis dans ma chambre. Regardez, il y a du nouveau stock. Il y a même une guitare et des bottes de pluie. Il y a des nouvelles choses. Donc, je pense qu'il y a des gens qui sont venus apporter des choses à donner. Et je trouve ça vraiment bien. Il y a un gros stock de linge pour bébé. L'initiative a fait des petits et les gens ont participé. Mon fuel est consommé. Comme ça, mon magasin libre et gratuit de regard. J'ai pris des choses. Je vais laisser des choses. Regarde, il y a des nouvelles choses, cette chaise, c'était pas là. Alors, je constate vraiment que les gens ont apporté des choses. C'est génial. C'est quoi ça? Penses-tu que c'est une machine pour laver les tapis? J'ai amené quelques livres. Donc, vous avez du Margaret Atwood. Le livre Brooklyn, il y a eu le film, là. J'avais le livre. Et Mishima. J'en reviens pas que ça, ça n'a pas été pris. L'œuvre d'art, c'est magnifique. J'en ai pas des vertes. C'est ça mon style, ça. J'en ai souvent vert. Mais bon, j'ai des oranges, j'ai des mauves. Ça, c'est un peu intriguant, ça, non? Je vais peut-être essayer ça.
Cool! jamais les pièces uniques. Là, regarde-le.
C'est très Casey Neistat, surtout les blanches. I have enough sunglasses as it is. And last but not least, remember last year I put some stickers over there on the cake? Well, some people sent me stickers. Some people sent me stickers during the winter. So we're gonna go stick them up. I checked the other day and only the moose from Van City Van Life was still there, but it looks kind of like they scraped something off. I'm pretty sure I put one of mine. I'm pretty sure I put more than that. So I don't know why the moose is still there. Couldn't get rid of the moose. I was surprised anything was still there. So stick or not, your stickers are very sturdy. I appreciate them because they last. You put them in the city, you go there a year later, the sticker's still there. You can see sometimes that people try to take them off, but they can't. So I'm really, really pleased with the quality of the Sticker Nut stickers. So you got mine. I got a few from Van City Van Life. Sometimes Chrome sends me a pack because I'm the Quebec ambassador. I just put some in Montreal the other day. So Van City Van Life. Got Cruise the Bulldog. Yup, I'm weird. Weirdos Unite. This is one of my last ones. I'm running out of these and I don't think he makes them anymore. Yeah, these are rare. Collector's items. And then some that I got from people this winter or in 2020. Pete Seeger Bus. I got Throwbot. This is the company that makes the subscribe pillows. And Strong's Adventure, Gillian Ronda. I need more people. If you want to have a sticker in Lévis, Quebec, Canada, send it to our PO Box. See how other stickers don't resist the test of time, but ours do. So Sticker Nut, we recommend them. And it's a Canadian company. Gotta be quick because my hometown is really not the kind of city that would be okay with that. And there's a lot of police around, so if ever I get caught, I'm gonna get in trouble. Want to be part of the sticker wall in Lévis, Quebec? Send me your stickers. Get the hell out of here.
Some people might have a question, Isabel.
What is it, Pancho?
Who's gonna take care of Mary?
Oh, my dad's gonna take care of Mary. That's gonna give him something to do. And he just had a birthday, by the way.
He turned 28. Young.
Yeah, we got good genes. He's actually 93, but you don't really want to remind someone who's 93 that they just turned 93. So there was an inside joke when I was a kid. I don't know why I thought my dad was 28, probably because he told me he was 28 or something. And then I would argue with people that my dad was actually 28 and I really believed it, but he was like 60 something. So that's why I put 28 on the cake.
How old am I?
You're 5, Pancho.
I'm 5. I'm young.
Oh, and we would like to say thank you to our subscriber, Suzanne Maybush. I hope I'm pronouncing your name well, from Australia. We got a really cool postcard.
And if you look really carefully, it has a koala stamping on it.
Yeah, it's really cool. It's called a Dunart. I had never heard of this animal. So that's it for us.
See you on the West Coast.
Ok, c'est Wind of Change. Ils vont-tu la chanter en français? Over summer night, soldiers passing by, listen to the wind of change.